Welcome to Analytics with Nax. In this session, we're going to see about a new DAX function called path function. The path function is part of parent-child functions. And there are a lot of other functions which is categorized as parent-child functions. Those who are not familiar with what is parent-child, let us try to understand what is parent-child relationship is. The best example is employee information or employee table, where you have employee information, ID, name, designation, these three columns belongs to an employee. And we have a manager ID, which is nothing but this column references again employee ID. This is the foreign key, which is referring again the same table, that is employee ID. This is what a parent child. What I mean, if you see the row number 3, that is 103, that is he is a DCO, who's manager? Basically, manager nothing but he reports to CEO. Let us take another example, 110. That is, he is a developer, he reports to 105. 105 is nothing but TL, and the TL in turn reports to DCO, and DCO reports to 101, that is CEO. So this is the hierarchy it is followed. If you navigate through these two columns, you will get the hierarchy. This is what a parent-child relationship is all about. Those who are working in SQL, they are familiar with this kind of architecture. And in order to get who is the manager name, that is a typical SQL interview question you will get. So you will join the same table twice to in order to get the manager name. This is fine. This is a different part of the story. So now you are clear with what is parent-child relationship is. Now, what are these parent-child functions in DAX? Why it is useful? So when you are working with this kind of relationship, you need to get the complete path of the entire hierarchy so that you have some calculations in your business. That is why these parent-child functions are useful. So one such a function is called path function. What it does? It returns a delimited text string with the identifiers of all parents of the current identifier, starting with oldest and continuing until current. Basically, like when you consider 110, as I said, how we navigated. So 105 is your TL, and for this TL, DCO is the reporting, and for the DCO, you have CEO. So like that, the complete path, this particular DAX function will return. Let's try to see it in action. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So we have this employee information, whatever we have seen before. Now, in order to get the hierarchy path, right, the complete path, we can use this path function. So let us try to create a new column in this table. Let me name it as hierarchy, since it is trying to give us what is the complete hierarchy path. So path is the DAX function, and we need to refer the employee ID. The syntax is very simple. You can see ID column and the parent column. Our ID column is nothing but employee ID. That is employee ID, and parent column is nothing but manager ID. So it is MNGR manager ID. That's it. So it is a very simple syntax, path of employee ID, manager ID. Now we can able to see how this path has been generated. Now for this DCO, he reports to 101. 101 is nothing but CEO. So now starting from the topmost level, top level to bottom level, let's try to understand this particular developer. He reports to 105. 105 is TL. So you can see 105 reports to 102. Is that correct? Let's see. 105 reports to 102. So that is why we have this data. 102 reports to 101. 102 reports to 101. So that is the entire path. And you can notice this particular record where 114 reports to 103 directly. even though the designation is developer, he reports directly to a DCO, and DCO in turn reports to CEO. So you can skip the levels, you can imagine how this organization looks like. All the employees, you have a CEO, DCO, manager, TL, and developer, something like that. But I think most of them not reporting directly to managers. There is some issue in the data, that is fine. Everyone reports directly to DCOs. That's fine. It's based on the data. So now you can have some skipping of levels as well, right? In no need of stricter hierarchy, like developer should report to TL, TL should report to manager. It's either way, right? You can have some skipping of levels. You can directly see it here. So this is the navigation path. Basically, who reports to what, you can get the entire hierarchical path here. I hope this you understand. This is as a first step. We try to understand what is parent-child relationship and what does the path function will give to us. Based on this, we have different scenarios. We will try to cover it in next videos. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Do remember that data is your asset.